Firepower Squad, and we're in the boardroom having a meeting, going over last week and planning out this week what our goals are, plans, and that brought the topic of wholesaling. I wanted Ethan's opinion on what he thinks so far of the process. This is a big week coming up. This is going to change everything, so I wanted his feedback on what he thinks of wholesaling so far. Is it easy? Is it hard? Is it something he thinks that, you know, the regular person can go out and do it, you know, as a side hustle, or what are his thoughts? I have my opinions, and I want to get his feedback, so we're about to do some cardio here and let the meeting begin. Well, I don't know if your guys are going to be able to hear this, but it is what it is. So that was what do you think of wholesaling so far? What do you think, is it easy? Is it something anybody can do? What are your thoughts so far, your feedback, going into this big week we're going into right now?
Well, I don't know if they're going to be able to hear.
No, just talk. Talk loud, that's why I'm talking loud.
Well, like I said, what are you saying, damn thing?
What are you bringing that? What do you want to say with that? Just talk louder. We don't have the microphone. This is the only shit we have, so I didn't know that we have that. That's why I'm talking louder. So what? By you saying that, what do you want me to do? You want to stop the video? Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm just saying that we could go to a different environment.
No, this is the boardroom. That's what we're working on. That's why I said at the beginning, the volume's going to be like that. Just talk louder. You can't talk louder?
All right. Ask the question again.
For the third time. What's your feedback on wholesaling? Do you find it easy, hard? Is it something that anybody can do? Like, you know, one of your friends, one of your bosses at these little jobs here?
Well, you know what I would say? I would say that it's an extremely simple process, but you have to have dedication. Without dedication, you're going to easily give up. We've been wholesaling real estate every single day for the past 4 or 5 months, ongoing 6 months. And we're just now seeing progress. So anyone can do it. If you have a brain and you can see and hear and move your legs and hands, you can wholesale real estate. Are you going to be good at it? Who knows? It takes time. It takes dedication. And it really just takes, you know, just not giving up. I can say now there's been days where we piss off, but you know it still works through that through those days. But to answer the question, well, yes, anyone can wholesale real estate. It's just about how much time you want to invest into yourself.
So this is my feedback, my personal opinion. If anybody, you know, the manager at McDonald's, your cousin, anybody random wants to get into it, my personal opinion, to me, wholesaling is fucking easy. But I have the knowledge in construction, in sales, and in real estate. So I found that easy for me to transition into wholesaling. Now, somebody that has no knowledge, I think you need to know sales. You have to be a salesperson. You have to know your marketing, and you have to know your construction numbers. You have to do your research. So in my opinion, like he was saying, we've been hitting it really like 3 months, but we started like 4 or 5 months before, so let's just call it 6 months, hitting it hard. So unless you got, you know, a savings to hold you off for 6 months, and that's not including the construction knowledge, and assuming that you have some sales and you've done some research, you give it 6 months, all in, 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, you'll get there.
Yeah, but let's be realistic here, okay?
But nobody's gonna do that. Yes. So if you're gonna do it as a side hustle, my biggest tip will be it's gonna take you like a year. So don't focus on quick money. It's not gonna happen. Especially if you don't have no construction or sales skills. You gotta start from scratch. You gotta figure out where your real estate networking events are. You gotta start meeting people, getting on the Facebook things. You gotta start marketing yourself, sales. That's gonna take a lot for one person. This guy's over here always sleeping and on the gym. he's counting on me. I'm doing a lot in the behind the scenes. I'm trying to get him to understand and learn, and he doesn't get it.
But don't you say all the time, meet the marketing else you?
Yeah.
So I don't understand why you're pissed at me.
I'm not pissed at you.
I'm creating
a marketing.
Fucking down.
I'm not talking down on you. Because I've been telling you this is not the first time. I hate repeating myself. I don't hire my crew that I have to micromanage. I get it. I tell you once, twice. If I have to repeat it 3, 4, 5 times, you're an idiot. It's that simple. You're not paying attention and your mind is somewhere else. Focus over here or focus wherever it is and your mind is wandering off to you. So by marketing, I mean, the little clicks that you're doing, we want to generate traffic to our freaking YouTube. That's what we're pounding on the big money. So, when you guys, like you say, you got nothing to do instead of listening to that music and watching the stupid shit that you're watching on YouTube, you should be posting on Facebook pages like I do at 3, 4 in the morning that I'm there fucking doing shit and trying to generate traffic and get us known. People are starting to see us, all these ninja watches. So, that's the shit that people don't see behind the scenes, all the stress, okay, how do I market, what's working, what's not working. I don't go to sleep and then wake up and go have my oatmeal. Whoa, let's go. What are we doing today? That's an employee. Fucking boss and entrepreneur takes the initiative. I don't have to be telling you this. We're going into a closing right now. His life is about to change and this guy's listening to rap music instead of fucking be researching on YouTube University about closing, double closing, agreements, da da da. I think I've done more research than he does. He has. I want it. He's the one that came up to me and said he wanted millions. I didn't know millions was listening to rap music.
I mean, we already did. We know that aspect of double closing.
Doesn't matter. Everything. There's always something to do. The point is that you're listening to rap music like you're on vacation. He's still broke. We're still broke. I was like, have that attitude when we got fucking money in the bank. Then, yeah, it's going to change. But right now, that you don't have it, you should be fucking wanting it. So I was like, money only amplifies who you are. So when we get money, this is going to be it. More amplified, it's going to be lazier. We're never going to reach those millions. True or not? Have I said, is this the first time I mentioned it, or have I mentioned it several times already?
Nope, you say it all the time. But realistically, anyone can wholesale construction knowledge or not, because the information is out there. Zach gives you a free construction quote list, kind of. So as long as you know what kind of repairs are needed by using the list, then you should be fine. But I guess it does help a lot to have exact numbers and not contact by your side all the time.
Yeah, better than any list. If it's not specifically to your city or area, I would just get 3 quotes every time until you start getting familiar with the numbers. Get 3 quotes and compare apples to apples. You can't go wrong with that. It's a little more time consuming until you figure it out, and then you start realizing by square footage, you know, and the damage of a house. Like me, I just looking at a house, walking in, I just need the square footage and I already know what the rehab is gonna be. Because I'm a fucking goat. Bro, I'm a fucking goat for you. The marketing that's gonna come out right now, I just can't wait. Right now, for this week, I don't give a shit about the money. The only reason why I want the money is for what I'm gonna do with the marketing. That shit's gonna change the fucking game. The feedback, and if anybody can do it, it's a little upset, but it's okay. We're trying to make him a millionaire before he's 30.
Yes, simply,
yeah, I think anybody can do it, just it's not going to be a get rich quick thing from one day to another, especially if you're not good in sales and you don't know any construction numbers. It's gonna take you time to figure that out and learn it. If you don't have any connections into real estate, it's gonna take you time to get on those Facebook pages and find out your local network real estate networking events to go and meet cash buyers and other wholesalers. Once you get those things down packed, and let's say you're out there driving for dollars on the weekends, I would say give it like 6 months to a year before you can quit your job and start doing it full time. That all depends on you, how consistent you are. And the biggest tip I can give is document everything. Start your YouTube channel and just put it up there. And you're cool and you're doing good, you'll create a following and you can bank on that YouTube internet money.
Very simple process.
Yeah, the process is simple. I always tell it. I know I'm a good salesman. I'm a good people person. I know how to market. I was like, once I figure out the process, bro, there's no stopping me, bro. I already know. I bet on me. I already know. And with this kid is fucking a genius over here. I make it look easy, so that's why he's comfortable, so I don't blame him. Bro, you've been saying that since you've been on that floor since you first moved in. If you were really that comfortable, dog, you wouldn't be at the gym. I already told you, like me, when I was fucking started Willpower, when I was the racing, your focus, all you eat shit is whatever is making you money. And you're not like that, so don't tell me I'm not comfortable. You're fucking comfortable, dog. I think the only discomfort that you might have is that you don't eat as much as you would like to eat or what you are usually used to your mom cooking or whatever the type of food. I think that's going to be the biggest luxury when you get this check. You're gonna be like, fuck, let's go to Outback, yeah, let's go to the Green Tomato. I'm fucking eating this whole buffet, sir. Sir, how many people did you order this buffet for? Sir, you can't keep using the bathroom and, you know, unloading and reloading and food. Yeah, you're fucking comfortable, Bob.
I mean, I do go to the gym at 6 in the
morning. Well, you've gotten that a little bit better, but still, but it's not that. I don't care, dog. You're missing the big picture, the big point. I don't give a fuck. You can come to the gym, but when you're listening, when you're taking advantage, you're knocking two stones with one. This is fucking boot camp. This is fucking college. And you don't treat it like that. You treat it like it's a pastime and you I'm, like I said, I make this shit look so easy. I'm so good because I know I'm going to be rich. I already know it. You're feeding off of that. So you're like posting. You're like, I know. I trust this guy. I know we're going to be rich. So fucking chilling. That's going to happen. That's good. You're not chasing the money, so to speak, and you're being a little patient. But still, you should be more like this attitude you have now should be after we start fucking up, like in March, summertime. Like I said, when you got your fucking room, you got the Corvette outside, then yeah. But right now, you should. Remember, there's always somebody, it's like boxing, there's always somebody hungrier than you. That's the biggest downfall when they make it, is balancing the fame and going out to the parties and all that shit, the endorsement, and the training for the next fight. And the other guy that's always coming is a poor guy that lost his mom, and he's got something to prove, and he's watching more, and then boom, the champ gets knocked out because he got, what is it, good times make soft men, hard times make weak, strong men. It's that simple, Don. Like I said, you know I read people, and I can tell you're comfortable, and I get that. And unfortunately, it's not gonna get any better because we're about to get rich. So, what else? What else? Change it every time you get bored, you can go and do a wrap. The interior is the one that's a bitch, that one is always going to be that color. And I see the interior of that car, the orange, the blue, fucking any color, red, any color, that interior is the baddest color.
I'm not sure.
and they have that Lamborghini flavor, the colors. Lamborghini has those Skittles colors, but Vette has that too. So you can get crazy with the colors.
Orange with orange,
and black interior, yellow with yellow and black, and blue with blue and black. So many. Any interior with a black. Ooh, yellow with black. Orange with black, the blue with black. What else, man? You're killing your memory. A whole week, and we got a big week coming up, and he has nothing to talk about.
He's cut the camera.
Oh, he's pissed off. Bro, it's a doggy dog world, dog. Imagine fucking, what do you call it, though? Why are you mad? Talk. This is the war room.
I'm not mad at all.
Bro, I can tell him. You didn't tell me you're not mad. I can tell by your tone and your demeanor. I already know.
Bro,
I'm not mad. Bro. Okay, not mad. You're
still
upset.
I guess I'm tired of this.
Shit.